the most famous Polish-born dancer from who danced in Russia with the Imperial Ballet and the Ballet Russe, and he transformed ballet and dance really forever. He was the very beginning of that point where ballet became, especially for the male, became not about, you know, the man who picks up the woman and makes her look beautiful. Nijinsky, actually, it was the first male star. He was the first male dancer who was able to take a character in dance and to make it utterly believable to the point where people were absolutely mesmerized. And through his dance, he was able to embody the essence of what he was actually dancing.
In a way that as you were to look at the photographs, could you feel that? Could that tap into something inside you?
The hard thing in this project was actually that how can we get in? You know, we took maybe 5 days or 6 days trying different ideas and different pictures, and was not really what we were looking for. I remember we were both quite disappointed about it. We thought it would be so easy because the idea was so clear. But it was really hard, and at the end we figured out that maybe the only possibility that we could work, it was actually trying to get inside his work and his personality as a door in, but bringing it through my body and through the moment that we are now. It was impossible to try to reproduce or to try to go back in time. The only possibility was to break inside his work and his soul something new, through my body and through her photography.
I wanted to have a feeling in the whole piece, basically, of containment, as well as certain moments of real expression and light. So I set about doing that. I composed most of it all on piano, and then I've orchestrated it since then. And the piece goes for about 8 minutes, and the two sections are quite different, but the essence in both of them, they both have an essence in an element of stillness. The ability to be still affords you great freedom, but it can also, it's also something that can be like being entrapped as well. So I wanted to somehow express the tension in those two polar ideas in the music.